Kirchhoff's voltage law verification. These are the equipments required for this experiment. This is the kit for KVL. Again, we need multimeters for the measurement of voltage. And this is the again DC supply, which comprises of two voltage sources, V1 and V2. Now here we have connected 4 voltmeters with the help of multimeters. You can see we are using multimeter in voltmeter mode. So here we are using 4 multimeters. 3 multimeters are required for the measurement of voltage drop across the resistances, and 4th one is for nodal voltage measurement. This is the circuit we are considering. Here we are going to verify KVL in these 2 loops. So as you can see in the circuit here, this resistance is 390 is R1, this 820 is R2, and this third resistance is 1.2 kilo ohm. So first step will be, you will just observe these values and note it down. So here I have noted down the readings of resistances. Then if we apply KVL in loop, so first we will consider this loop, and the loop voltages will be V1, V3 and V4, where V3 and V4 are the voltage drops and V1 is the source voltage. So if we apply KVL here, the equation will be V1 plus V3 plus V4 is equal to 0, the arithmetic sum of voltages in a closed loop. Here I am showing you the observation table. Here we have V1, V3, V4 for loop 1, and for loop 2 we are considering again 3 voltages, V2, V4 and V5. So we are going to measure all these voltages with these multimeters. Now for first reading, as you can see, we have set the applied voltage V1 at 5 volts. So I am noting down 5 here for V1 reading. And V2 is 5 volts. So these 2 will be the observed values for source voltage. Now this voltage is V3. V3 is this voltage. So I am noting down it 0.871. As you can see, its reading is 0.871. And then this multimeter will read, V4. And I am noting it down 4.24. So these 3 readings, if I add these 2, it will be equal to 5. Or if I take the correct polarities, the addition of these 3 will be equal to 0. So these 3 are the measured values. Now similarly, for second loop, the V2 we are applying is 5 volts. And again, the V4 is 4.24. So I am noting it down. It is 4.24, and V5 is this, it is 1.089. So again I am verifying the KVL here. This is actually 5.2 here, so I am taking 5.2 here. So in this way we can verify the KVL practically by performing the experiment.